For us who are the devotees of the Supreme Truth, may the winds blow sweetly, may the rivers flow sweetly, may the herbs be to us sweet and beneficial, may there be sweetness during the day and during the night, may the particles of the earth be carrying sweetness forever, may the heavens, our Father, be sweet to us, may the sun be sweet and benevolent to us, may the cows give us the sweetest milk. Living in harmony with nature has been an integral part of Indian culture. The worship of Mother Earth is a universal phenomenon. Today, we all are victims of environment degradation and its disastrous consequences. In this video, I have made a small attempt to look upon our own traditional ethics of nature conservation. Hope this will definitely be our source of inspiration and guidance to look after our environment. If we talk about 10,000-year-old cave paintings at Bhimbetka in central India, we see birds, animals, human beings living in harmony. The worship of trees, animals, forest, rivers, sky, the sun, and the Mother Earth were part of Indian tradition since time unknown. The Vrikshayurveda says planting a tree equally beneficial as having 10 suns. Let us talk about sacred groves. Sacred groves are patches of forest around places of worship. These are traditionally protected. The local people do not allow to cut even a single branch of a tree. Through faith, belief, religious practice, activities, and community participation, conservation of biodiversity takes place. Sacred groves are mainly found along western coast, western ghats, Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Maharashtra. Hundreds of small jungles dedicated to snakes in Kerala. These are known as Sarpa Kavu. Sarpa means snake, Kavu means jungle. The greatest example of sacred groves is the jungles around the sacred hill of Sabarimala with an Ayyappan temple. Government of India identified 2,163 sacred groves in tribal heartland of Odisha. These sacred groves are an integral way of life for 9.6 million tribal people in Odisha. Human interference is prohibited in these areas. Many plants and animals have, from historical times, been considered sacred in India. The most outstanding examples are peepal tree, द बनियान ट्री, सैंडलवुड ट्री, मैंगो ट्री, चंपा, तुलसी प्लांट्स एट्सेट्रा. मोर देन 100 सच स्पेसिस ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड ट्रीज इन इंडिया आर कंसिडर्ड सैक्रेड. द पीपल ट्री इज नोन एज ट्री ऑफ लाइफ. इट रिलीजेस ऑक्सीजन इवन एट नाइट. ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ पीपल ट्री इज यूजफुल. इट कैन क्योर एज मेनी एज 50 डिजॉर्डर्स. According to Skandha Purana, Lord Vishnu was born resided under a peepal tree. The roots of this tree represent Brahma, the trunk represents Vishnu, and the leaves represent Shiva. In Hindu religion, Batavriksha or Banyan tree is the most sacred tree. It is a perfect personification of something very strong firm on the ground. About Tulsi, many legends are found in Vedic literature. Tulsi means matchless. It is believed that Tulsi is physical incarnation of Goddess Lakshmi on the earth. Tulsi has great healing power. It has medicinal properties as well as it helps in boosting immune system.
Mahaprasada Janani Sarva Saubhagya Vardhini आदि व्याधि हरा नित्यं तुलसीत्वं नमोस्तुते तुलसीत्वं नमोस्तुते.
इंडियन टेक्स्ट सच एज अर्थशास्त्र, वेदस, मनुस्मृति, रामायण, महाभारत हेल्प अस टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल कंजर्वेशन एंड फॉरेस्ट इकोलॉजी. Kautilya, better known as Chanakya, was a minister of Chandragupta Maurya. He wrote Arthashastra. This book put forth great importance on safeguarding and managing forest, gardens and orchards. There were directors of forest, superintendent of cattle, horse, elephants. They were given tasks to protect and safeguard wildlife. For cutting any part of tree, fines were imposed those days. Similarly, in post-Vedic age, Manusmriti was written by Maharshi Manu. It also put stress on environmental protection. During those periods, as per Manusmriti, great importance was given for protection of animals, biodiversity, and vegetarian food habit. Rig Veda talks about nature. Varuna, Maruta, Indra were worshipped. There was a general feeling in Vedic text that all animals should be safe, protected, healthy. The Atharva Veda prays for continuous growth of herbs. Hence, it is concluded that environment belongs to all, so needs protection by all for the welfare of all. So, let us take a pledge to protect our environment and protect the human race.
Samudra vasane devi parvatastana mandale Vishnu patni namastubhyam padasparsham.